Hi everyone, this is Travis Sabin, Product Manager for Adobe Analytics, and today I'm going to be walking you through how to set up and configure the new Advertising Analytics feature. So to get started, I've brought us to our documentation, and it outlines four steps for getting Advertising Analytics set up and configured. So first step is to provision your Advertising Analytics reporting per report suite. So whichever report suites you want this data to be sent to, there's two major pieces you need to do that are extremely important. So the first one is to map your report suite to your IMS org. So come to the report suite mapping tool, select which report suite you want to map, which organization you want to send it to, and then get it mapped appropriately. That'll take just a minute, and then once it's mapped, that first piece is done. The second step is to come to the report suite manager, and under the settings, you need to enable the Advertising Analytics configuration for that given report suite. So click on Advertising Analytics Configuration, and you'll be presented with the Advertising Analytics Reporting section where you can determine the allocation and expiration of the data. And then I've already configured this, so my Enable button is no longer here, but there'll be a big Enable Advertising Analytics Reporting. You'll click on that, and it will save and load, and then you'll be presented with this screen that says now Save Advertising Analytics Reporting if you want to update or change your allocation or expiration settings for the future. So that is step one, a very important step. If you don't do those two pieces first, you won't be able to save or configure your actual accounts later on. So make sure you do those two things at the very beginning. Second, we're going to actually go through setting up an Advertising Analytics account. So I'm going to come over to Analytics, I log in, and I'm under the admin menu. I can go directly here to Advertising Analytics, or from the dropdown, I can select Advertising Analytics. And when this loads, the first time you come in, you will be presented with an end user license agreement. You'll agree to that, and that will start the APIs firing off in the back end to get some of the sweet sauce working. And then there'll be a big blue button to create a new search account. Since I've already have some set up for this test, I'll just click on the plus add right here to add an additional one, and I'll show you this menu as well. So in here, there are kind of three sections and steps you need to walk through in order to get your advertising account configured. The first one is to set the search engine settings. Now, we have three search engines that are available to you through this new feature, the Google AdWords, Bing Ads, or Yahoo Gemini search engines. And the setup for them is all very similar. There are only a few minor differences. For Google and Yahoo, they look pretty much like this. The only difference between Google and Yahoo is that the name down here for this ID will change to Yahoo account ID. But Bing has one additional field that is required, and it's kind of a tricky one. It's hidden over here in the kind of the middle. It's an additional customer ID that they request in order to properly connect the accounts. So please be aware of that if you're doing Bing ads as well. So I'll do Google just for today, but first thing you'll do after you select which search engine you want to do, you'll give it a friendly account name. This can be whatever name you want it to be. It doesn't have to be the name that you use within AdWords. It can be something completely different. Whatever will help you identify and distinguish it from your other search accounts. Then you will retrieve your Oauth token, which will allow you to connect Google AdWords and Analytics together. If you see this here, efrontier.com, and don't be alarmed, that is some of our underlying legacy technology that we are using. We're not diverting you to some third-party site to do something that you don't want to do. So just know about that. But you'll go through and select which email account you want to connect it to, and you'll enter your credentials and get that authenticated. And then lastly, you'll locate and provide your account ID. Our documentation will walk you through where to find that if you're unfamiliar with where that ID might be located. And then the next section is the tracking section. This tracking section is a little bit more technical, and we'll provide a subsequent video to walk you through how to do this step by step, but the instructions for it are here. You can click on that, and that will open up the documentation. What you'll need to do is copy the SQUID ID that we've created and append it to your URL in order to begin the tracking. Again, follow the instructions to make sure that you do this correctly to add it to your tracking templates. Once you have this added, the last thing to do is to map it to your report suite. So if you have not done the first step that we mentioned about mapping it to your IMS org or to your enabling the Advertising Analytics settings for the report suite, you will not have any report suites listed here. I only did one, so I have one report suite that's available. But if you don't have any, you can click here and it'll help you get that set up to go back to those initial steps that we talked about. So you'll select the report suite. And once you do that, you will have the option to save. I'm not actually going to set one up, so I don't have that here, but I have three already set up. And then once you have it done, it will appear here in the menu. And then the first time you set up an account, it takes anywhere from 24 to 48 hours for that data to get processed and activated and start coming in. And then your data will sync on a nightly basis every day. So your data will always be kind of one day behind with this integration. And so that is setting up your search account. So step three is reporting. So we'll go back to analytics, and we have built a custom template specifically for this new feature. So if I come to Workspace and I have the list of templates here, at the bottom I have a new one titled Search Engines. I'll double click on that. And once it loads, if my default report suite is not one that has been mapped appropriately given the two steps we had to do before, then I'll be given this warning and an opportunity to change it to the correct report suite. So I'll change it to my report suite that's been configured. And once I get this configured, I have this pre-built report with a lot of great data already in it set aside for me to come in and start getting some real cool insights quickly and easily here within analytics. We pass in five specific metrics: AMO impressions, clicks, cost, average position, and average quality score. There are others, but these are the five main metrics that we're passing in with this integration. These five metrics come in as summary level data sources, which means they cannot be combined or broken down with other analytics metrics, classifications, or dimensions. However, you can add additional analytics metrics here on the end and combine them with these specific AMO dimension classifications. That post-click activity can be broken down by the dimensions that are being brought in through this integration. So in this report, we have a lot of different pre-built tables. So we have just our general metric count here by day. We have keywords across however many platforms. I have three platforms set up. So this is keywords across all three of my search engines. These are the different three platforms I have right here. I can see how they're performing against one another. The various accounts, campaigns, or groups, and ads. All of that is pre-built, no work required. You come in, and once your data has been processed, it will begin showing up in here and populating these different fields. Obviously, you can still come in and do any customization you want. You can start from scratch and start utilizing these same metrics and dimensions to build your own reports and dashboards for your own teams. But we've built this template with this specific feature in mind to give you something out of the gate to quickly gain insights and report on it immediately. And then lastly is just managing these accounts. So if you come back over here, we come back to the advertising analytics menu, you can use this menu here to do additional report suite mapping if you want. We can do one-to-one, many-to-one, or many-to-many report suite mapping under this section here. We can also change the status of various accounts, and we can change them from active to paused, and that will allow you to do your search engine management here. This is advertising analytics, and hopefully this has been helpful in helping you understand how to configure and set up advertising analytics for your paid search accounts for you and your company. Thank you.